Test, 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 test. Test, test, test. Test, test. Testing 1, 2, 3, 4.
Subcommittee will come to order. And pursuant to notice, we are here this afternoon to mark up H.R. 2140, the Vietnam Human Rights Act of 2015, and H.R.S. 213, condemning the April 2015 terrorist attack at the Garissa University College in Garissa, Kenya, and reaffirming the United States' support for the people of the government of Kenya and for other purposes. The first measure, the Vietnam Human Rights Act, I introduced along with eight co-sponsors. It is a bipartisan bill. It is the fourth time this legislation is making its way through the Congress. Three other times it passed the House, but regrettably was not taken up in the Senate. Our hopes are that this year it will be. And the H.R.S. 213 was introduced by my good friend and colleague, Ms. Bass, and that too is a bipartisan resolution that will make its way to the floor very, very shortly after full committee consideration. Due to the bipartisan support for these measures, the fact that the subcommittee will reconvene following the markup for a hearing, as well as scheduling of other events and floor activity, it is the intent of the chairman to consider these measures in block. I understand that our staffs have been in communication, and Ms. Bass has graciously consented to this. I also understand that Mr. Burra may also wish to further consult with regard to the Vietnam Human Rights Act in advance of the full committee markup with regards to provisions dealing with labor protections. All members have copies of these documents before them, which were circulated to you on Tuesday. And after we have concluded our expedited consideration, I'll be glad to recognize any member, including myself and the ranking member and our distinguished colleagues to my right, for any comments they might want to make on the pending legislation. All members are given leave to insert written remarks into the record, should they choose to do so. Seeing that we do have a reporting quorum present, without objection, the following are considered as read and will be considered en bloc. H.R. 2140, the Vietnam Human Rights Act of 2015, and H.R.S. 213, condemning the April 2015 terrorist attack at the Garissa University College in Garissa, Kenya, and reaffirming the United States' support for the people and government of Kenya and for other purposes. The chair moves that the en bloc items be adopted. All those in favor say aye. Aye. All those opposed say no. The ayes have it, and in the opinion of the chair, the items considered en bloc are adopted. Without objection, the measures as amended are reported favorably to the full committee, and the staff is directed to make technical and conforming changes. I would note that we now have completed our formal consideration of these measures, and I would recognize members for remarks that they might want to make. Although we have witnessed the release, and I'd like to first speak to the Vietnam Human Rights Act of 2015, although we have witnessed the release of some political prisoners in Vietnam, we should not be fooled or deceived into believing that the release of a few dissidents somehow represents real progress on human rights in Vietnam. The underlying reality of repression in Vietnam is fundamentally unchanged. The government of Vietnam continues to hold prisoners of conscience whose so-called crimes are only their attempts to exercise universally recognized human rights. Since the State Department removed the country of particular concern designation with respect to religious freedom in Vietnam, the situation there has gotten worse, and I've heard from witnesses at hearings who have spoken of the particularly egregious situation that exists for ethnic and religious minorities. Forced renunciations of faith continue, and people and institutions in a wide range of faiths are harassed by authorities unless they submit to government control and interference. In order to show that we are serious about protecting human rights, there must be serious consequences for failure to make meaningful and systemic reforms that should take place. Increased commercial ties and military cooperation, frankly, should be off the table unless basic human rights standards are met. Respect for the freedoms of religion, expression, and assembly are a minimum. The U.S. must be unrelenting in its demands for improvement for human rights in Vietnam. If not, the repression will only get worse. This piece of legislation would institute effective measures towards improving human rights in Vietnam. The bill prohibits any increase in non-humanitarian assistance over 2012 levels, when it was over $16 million, to a government of Vietnam unless it makes substantial progress in establishing a democracy and promoting human rights, including respecting freedom of religion and releasing all political religious prisoners, respecting rights of freedom of expression, assembly, and association, and releasing all political prisoners, independent journalists, and labor activists, repealing and revising laws that criminalize peaceful dissent, independent media, unsanctioned religious activity and nonviolent demonstrations in accordance with international human rights standards, respecting the human rights of members of all ethnic groups, taking all appropriate steps, including prosecution of government officials to end government complicity in human trafficking. The bill would not prevent increased funding to the Vietnamese government for certain humanitarian assistance, such as food, medicine, Agent Orange remediation, activities to combat human trafficking, or child labor. The Vietnam Human Rights Act seeks to bring balance to any future strategic partnerships by ensuring that the United States' interests in human rights, including freedoms of speech, religion, assembly, and association, and the rule of law, are an integral part of that bilateral relations. Its enactment will send an unmistakable message to Hanoi that human rights improvements are fundamental to better relations, critically linked to our mutual economic and security interests, and cannot be ignored or bargained away. I'd like to yield to any of my colleagues if they would like to perhaps comment on any of the resolutions pending.
Mr. Renner. Thank you, Mr. Chair, and thanks to your ranking member Bass for holding this important markup on two very important and timely pieces of legislation. In the last few months, I've traveled to both Kenya and Vietnam. House Resolution 123 condemning the April 2015 terrorist attack at the Garissa University College in Garissa, Kenya, and reaffirming the United States' support for the people and government of Kenya is vitally important. During my trip, I saw firsthand the devastation caused by the gruesome killings in Kenya and the diplomatic and humanitarian crisis it left, from security crises forced closure of refugee camps causing displacement across the country to the cancellation of remittances that people rely on. This attack has caused incredible harm. I fully support the bill and urge its passage. Just last week, I was in Vietnam and as a co-sponsor of H.R. 2140 to promote freedom, human rights, and the rule of law as part of the United States-Vietnam relations. I want to mention that the nation of Vietnam has made tremendous strides in the cause of human rights from what we observed, and that should not be lost in this conversation. But there is much left to do. During our trip to Vietnam, our delegation conveyed this to our Vietnamese hosts, and to their credit, they agreed. In other words, there is an ongoing dialogue. We must hold them accountable, and especially in the face of a major trade deal, it is absolutely necessary we ensure that any advancement in cooperation is met by continued advancements in human rights. I fully support both of these important bills and yield back.
Member, thank you so very, very much, Mr. Clausen.
Yield back. Very supportive.
Thank you. I would ask unanimous that my comments on the Kenyan resolution be made a part of the record, and I want to thank my colleagues for their participation and presence here today. This markup is concluded, and momentarily we'll begin the hearing on trafficking.